Шановні колеги, ми продовжуємо.
Esteemed colleagues, we continue our work. The topic of next event is innovative methods of diagnosing and treating diseases that can lead to children's autism. Our guest Oleksiy Yehorov, father of a child with autism, Volodymyr Stefanyshyn, director of IGP, Tetiana Skrypnyk, doctor of psychology, senior researcher of the Institute of Special Pedagogy of the National Academy of Pedagogical Sciences of Ukraine, also Christian Oleksiy Yanner, president of the NGO Ukrainian Social Coalition, Yulia Pavlovska, the founder of the charity fund Special Mother. She's also the mother of a child with autism. Tetiana Vishnevska, the head of the organization Kievsky Troyandy. The first one will be Oleksiy Yehorov. Please speak into the microphone. Good afternoon, friends. First of all, I thank you for this opportunity to draw your attention to this problem and to request the assistance to our child, Olenka. It's quite symbolic. It happened so that Olenka has her birthday today, so greetings to her. Let her be happy and healthy. Starting discussing this issue, I would like to draw attention to the fact that you never know what you can expect and the situation in which our families, it was a real unexpected situation. And nothing signaled that something bad should happen. First, I would like to say that the pregnancy, Natasha had an easy pregnancy, if you can say so. There were some moments during the birth, but I thank the doctors, they coped with everything perfectly well, everything was fine. And the signs of the problem that we'll be talking about started observing that when she was 4 months old. Before that, there was not a single doubt on how the child's developing. Everything was according to the plan, if you can tell the plan, call it the plan, the development of a child. Then we saw some signs that concerned us. Some skills were disappearing. The child stopped looking into the eyes, and we could feel that something's wrong. We asked the doctors, but the doctor said nothing bad, just wait, everything will be fine. I have doubts that they were doing it on purpose. They probably believed it and they wished us the best. But starting from the age of a child, 1 year and a month, and there were some signs of stereotypical movements that would repeat. The diagnosis at such an age is not set, but approximately at 1 year and 10 months, we met Tatiana Viktorovna. She will later tell us about that. And the child was diagnosed with autism. That was quite an unexpected shock for the family. When we were looking for answers, we talked to specialists, we individually were reading a lot of literature, and we saw the information on autism, and that was scary. And when they told us about that diagnosis, I went out, I talked to my wife, I said that, yeah, that's really so, but it scares a lot, because, you know, from the information that autism is something that is not curable. In the past, it was equal to children's schizophrenia. That's for the rest of your life. I believe that every father, parent of a child with autism could feel that, but then we started looking for first the methods of correction, because that's the best approach in this situation, not to look for the reason, do something with the child now. We worked with psychologists, with we attended the kindergartens, not everything was fine. We changed four kindergartens till we went to the kindergarten with mutual education. We never we were never giving up. We were looking for some material reason, because the brain, it's the structure which has its properties. We were looking for where is the mistake, where's the mistake and what. What led to functioning of a brain this way? I believe that Vladimir will tell about that in more detail. And eventually, after many exams, we found the pathology. And the answer that gave us hope, why? Because we found out that autism of Olenka is not just a pathology in itself, but it's something to which certain conditions led. The virus infection of neurotropic viruses and ruining of the white substance in the brain. We found our curator, Volodymyr, and his colleague, Dr. Maltsev, who told us about it. And they prescribed the scheme of treatment for a child. And now we are moving towards implementing this treatment. We started it. One thing that complicates the process, it does not complicate, but we are trying to prevent. At this moment, the medicines which are used with this treatment are very expensive, and the treatment will last for about 4-6 months and will cost about more than 600,000 hryvnias, and that is why we address charity organizations. And even this event, even now, I am asking to pay attention to that, all people who can help, because of treatment of Olenka, or thanks to the treatment of Olenka, we can find maybe the chance to treat children with autism. There are either 35% or 55% of those who have similar reasons. About 30% of population have this type of mutation, and they have the chance to be recover from autism. About 7-8 years ago, that would sound impossible, but now it has been confirmed by scientific research, and that is implemented into life. That is why I request to pay attention of all the of all people in Ukraine, those people who are working on correction and treatment of such disorders, and also fathers of children with autism, that maybe you will be able to find out the way out of your situation with a certain diagnosis. And I request people to help Olenka to recover. The next one is Volodymyr Stefanyshyn. I'm grateful that I met Oleksiy, the father of wonderful three daughters, but unfortunately, the middle daughter, Olenka, is a special child. We can believe, we can treat it as this is somebody else's child, but we need to understand, if we look at the statistical data in Ukraine, in the world, the number of children with autism is growing, and we need to understand that if we are not working on that, then children could be recognized as the population, because today about 3-4% of children from Ukraine have the disorders of the spectrum of autism. What is diagnosed is 1.5%, but I will talk about that in more detail. If there are certain genes, that so-called Mongolian mutation, the number of such children in Eastern countries is up to 5%. The development of the spectrum of autism in Ukraine and in Europe is a little bit different, because we have certain genetic mutations here as the basis for that. What I wanted to tell, as of today, it has been proven that different genetic disorders lead to the disorder of the spectrum of autism. Out of them, about 90%, that's the deficit of a violation of the exchange of the vitamin B12. Because we are here almost at the specialized press conference, the majority understand what we are talking about. The first, so what we get because of the mutation, the number of homocysteine increases, which is impacts strongly at the nervous system, and the second is it influences the number of natural killers that violates the immunity of cells, and in adult age that could lead to oncology diseases, immune diseases. In children's age, this is becomes the autism. The same situation happened, the same thing happened with the Olenka. We found three types of virus in Olenka, and this child has to have treatment stage by stage. Oleksiy was talking about 4 months, but I can tell you that's from 6 to 8, 9 months. Then the stage is that the correction of immune deficit. If we are talking about medicine, pharmaceutical treatment of children with disorders of autism, all mean some special medicines, and when such medicines are used, they say they're not effective, this is wrong. When there is a permanent destruction of the nervous system, no one of these medicines can work. We present such a preparation, which is considered to be the best, but everything should happen at its stage. Why I'm talking about that? The cost of treatment of these children depends on at what stage that was diagnosed, because the treatment is calculated per 1 kilogram of weight. Safika is Lenka has 7 kilograms. If we started it at 3 years of age, the cost of treatment would be 2-3 times less. 3 years ago, it could be 200,000 hryvnias. Now it's 600,000 hryvnias. One more thing, we discuss it because we need to understand that that's not a problem of correction teachers, psychologists. I am the former doctor. These are children's neurologists, immunologists, and everyone points at everyone else and say this is not our problem. We need to understand that that's a multidisciplinary problem. There is Professor Chuprik, a famous psychiatrist for children, who wrote a couple of books, and we need to understand that everything should be done together and all should be done stage by stage. And if with psychopedagogical correction, both parents are teachers, everything's fine, there's some system. But from the point of view of medication correction, we see that no one wants to work on this pathology. The children's psychiatrist understands what psychotropic medications they need, but they do not understand the immune system. Immunologists say that's not our pathology. Go to psychiatrist, and we need to understand that small children with the disorders of the spectrum of autism, these are same adults with sclerosis. And I call upon you, the problem is such, very often these children are not observed by children psychiatrists, but by teachers. The teachers who work in specialized schools, probably there are hundreds of them all over Ukraine, there are signs that the child has some disorder. And that is a typical example when they say that it's because of inoculation. Inoculation is just the trigger. If not the inoculation, the child could have got some flu, and then the result would be the same. Some infection could lead to that. So this is the child that develops normally. After some disease or inoculation, we get this reverse development. In 30% of children, we see streptococcus infection. If the child starting from 2-3 years has and the main thing is about 70-80% of these children have the problems with nutrition. Basically, you need to go for diagnostics. The cost of full diagnostics, when we can do what's with the immunity, is 3,000 hryvnias. The full spectrum of diagnostics is 3,000 hryvnias, and the early treatment is 200,000 hryvnias. Late treatment, 500,000. We need to understand that we develop, if we are developing a child starting from 3 years, that's one situation. When we start doing it at 6-7 years, that's a different situation. Why this treatment is so expensive? Because Alenka is seven, we cannot select the therapy because Alenka is 7 years old already. We need the expensive Austrian medications because they prove to be effective for immune correction. And unfortunately, we will not be able to replace them, but to substitute them by something else. And after certain immune correction actions, we will start the therapy, and the rest of the treatment will be using Ukrainian medicines. I've been working on that for 8 years. 30% of children, every third child is recovered 100%. The only thing is the correct diagnosis and beginning of treatment at the age of 3 or 4. Then the child catches up with children of same age, and no one will even suspect that the child was diagnosed autism. So Olenka, on the one hand, there is mutation. On the other hand, it should be corrected because the forecast for treatment is positive and we expect that we will get good results. I believe that's one of the things that will show that everything could be treated and those who support will follow how Olenka is developing, because that will be an example for many parents. When your child is has such diagnosis, you will not be surrendering. Tetiana Skrypnyk in the beginning, and the doctor of psychological sciences, thank you. And greetings to all those present, greetings to the colleagues. I'm glad to be together with you in this situation when in the center we have the child, a child which requires assistance. And we, and this is like a symbol of all the children who have to be in the center of attention of the community and the subject of care of the interdisciplinary team which we need to create. As to Olenka, I remember her from when she was 2 years old. And all the classical signs of autism were obvious then. Now we can see certain progress, and you can understand it. We understand that these are the parents who managed to achieve it, and it's good that in the family they have two younger sisters who are normally developing, and thanks to them, Olenka has no, does not get immersed into her stereotypic actions, because other children will not allow her to do that, and that is very important, because that's important for the full-fledged development of the family. But I know, and my colleagues who worked with Olenka know, 4 years ago, that was a child that could get to the cupboard trying to hide, and you could not take her from there, and her desire to be alone, to get rescued from the alliance surrounding, that was obvious. Now, what I would like to say, thanks to this event which is taking place here, this is very important to discuss this topic so that our professional approaches are harmonized. When we're talking about assistance to such children, the nature of autism is different. It is important that this component, biochemical component, neurophysiological component, is researched, is diagnosed, so that you could understand how to support a child. On the other hand, because I'm taking care of psychological and pedagogical component, I would like to say that unfortunately a lot is to be done here, because there's certain shortage of understanding of what are standards of providing qualified assistance. Unfortunately, we have such an approach when one direction, one method, or certain system of specialization is not harmonized, and domination of one approach becomes more popular, and sometimes that leads to wrong understanding that this is the only way out. What should be mandatory reality? The up-to-date understanding of organizing of organization of assistance to special children is related to the fact that there should be the curator of such approach, coordinator, who together with the parents will develop the strategy, which will include medical component, medical, psychological, pedagogical, and social. And when there is such an understanding of the whole activity of a child and understanding of how we all need to develop the social partnership between correction centers, between social institutions, medical institutions, and everyone who's taking care of a child, have to understand what they are working on, what are the results of the positive dynamics, how to measure that, so that the progress is felt every day. And this teamwork, this responsibility when you are following up the results, that is all we need to learn. And it is important for us who are engaged in to that topic. We need to understand how close our positions are. And we need to understand our need in building up the correct approach. And this will make possible the positive development of the situation. And we will be able to have clear standards of providing qualified assistance to such children in Ukraine. Thank you. Now, Christian Oleksiy Yehorov, he will be speaking Swedish, and Maria will be translating it into Ukrainian. On the 30th of March, Oleksiy contacted me to work together to establish contact to help Alenka.
And Ukrainian Social Coalition was informed about the situation, and we got from the parents of Alena documents and photo that confirmed the situation. And I was really impressed with the situation and the story I heard and I encountered, and I was impressed by heroic efforts of parents who fight for their child. I saw a trend that families like a family of Alona, there are a lot of such families in Ukraine, and all of them need help. I know that there are a lot of such families, and they need support. And it is difficult to get help. And also Oleksiy and Natalia, they are real parents. They really love their children. And the atmosphere of warmth children should be brought up in is present in their family. And they do everything possible in order that their child got what that she needs. This is respect, care, and love that will help her to that will help her to develop. And I am as a president of Ukrainian coalition, and our coalition decided to do everything possible in order to help this family and to resolve this problem and to stabilize the situation. And for Ukrainian Social Coalition, it was important that we have to act and be active in this. And once again, we see that children with special needs, those who are in not proper physical conditions, that the rights of such children are violated. And they are in negative situation, and we believe that they need support and they need proper protection. And once again, we get convinced that in Ukraine there are no proper mechanisms, and we see that the laws are on paper, but they are not implemented, and the UNO Convention on Children's Rights is not implemented properly, and the Ukraine does not provide enough in order to defend protect the rights of children. And I saw that in Ukraine there are thousands of families who suffer from this situation.
Rättigheter och barn med speciella behov. Idag är det utom all sin kritik.
And the Ukrainian Social Coalition witnessed the fact that the Ukrainian state does not provide the rights of children and do not put enough effort in order to implement the laws. And we stated it many times. And in the Ukrainian constitution, it is envisaged that all the citizens should be provided with the same level of rights. But in Ukraine, we see that some have more rights than others. That's why we believe that the family became the victim of such contradictions, these gaps that are in the sphere of protecting the rights of disabled. And if the state cannot provide proper protection, as well as civil society should help, and they should be active in the situation, and Christian communities and well-meaning people should intervene, and the Ukrainian Social Coalition should participate as an active player that can influence the situation. And the family of Alenka, I believe that they have the wish to move together with us, and we will try to help them to solve this problem. And I hope that Oleksiy and the family of Alena will feel support. And I believe that God is really concerned the situation in Ukraine, that children's rights are violated, and children with special needs, they are not socially protected and legally protected, and that is really disturbing, and we should improve the situation. And more disturbing is once and once again we see that the laws are violated. They are ignored. And children's rights are violated, and children are not properly protected. There is a lot of abuse in this area, and civil society and the state do not provide proper support.
Med kärlek, hopp och framtidshopp, allt det här som ett barn förtjänar och ska ha, att barn ska få vara just barn som Aljona.
And the Bible says that all people are equal and have the right to be loved, to be cared for, and for a good future. And if these rights are violated, if there are obstacles in this way, so well-meaning people should help in this case. They shouldn't just keep silence and witness it. Everyone have the right for development and the better future. So Ukrainian Social Coalition is a part of Christian community, and we believe that each Christian should act, and Christian community should be active in this area, and Ukrainian Social Coalition want to move in this direction and to show its active position. Moreover, I believe that if each of us who believe that he is a Christian, if he put effort in this, then the situation will improve. If people are active, we will be blessed by God, and we would be able will be able to resolve our problems.
Kristna i vårt land att börja agera. Det är för många i vår nation som går till kyrkan och ber, men det finns inget hjärta att agera personligen. Utan tro finns, utan några gärningar finns ingen tro.
That's why I call on everyone who believe that they are Christians. You should be more active. Those who attend churches, who pray, but you should show your faith in your actions, and everyone who believes that they are Christians, they should be active and support and defend those who need this protection.
Sin tur kan förändra saker.
Молитва сама по собі не має сили виправити положення.
And the prayer itself cannot change things, but it can change the person. And if the person changes, he or she can become more active and resolve problems. So we should be as radical as Jesus. He said, let children come to me and I will bless them. Let's be active in order to help our children to develop.
Som Alona är att vi sätter barnen i det första ledet, precis som Jesus gör. Så folk som kallar sig kristna i det här landet ska agera.
And children came to Jesus, he put his hand on his foreheads and blessed them. And we should care about our children. We should make their problems priority for our state in order to help as Jesus helped them. That's why I believe that it should be taken into account by politicians who raise these issues and that they put it low on the agenda in the list of issues to be resolved. And they should be more active to resolve the problems, especially those concerning children.
Ja, detta är mina ögon. Som jag som har levt upp i det svenska samhället är det här ju så långt ifrån ett bra samhälle och ett fungerande samhälle att man ska behöva ta ut sin identitet till hela folket för att få hjälp.
Отож, ця ситуація, що
the family addresses civil society and also the media in order to provide information about the situation to society. And I am a citizen of Sweden, and I believe that from this prospect, the situation is unhealthy. And we should act in order to remedy the situation, because once and once again we see that the situation is disturbing, and once again we see that the only way out for the families is to address to civil society, to well-meaning people.
Det som är att gång på gång så är det kampanjer om pengar för vård eller direkt till vård man vill ha, och sedan att man just utlämna sig på det här sättet, och sen när man tar kontakt med journalister i det här landet och så som exempel tar fram exemplet Alona och hennes pappa Oleksiy och Anastasia, och att detta blir som ett att detta är normalt beteende och det inte finns någonting intresse överhuvudtaget att ta upp detta, att barnet är inte tillräckligt sjukt för att det ska få synas i media, och detta det är bara att det gör mig väldigt irriterad att det detta är inte normalt, men detta är en sak vi har gjort normalt i Ukraina.
I have been working with these projects and I see an axiom that children in such families, they draw public attention in order to help. They address to the media in order to get support, and I believe that social sector should help in resolving these problems, but and the families, they address civil society, and this is disturbing, and the situation is unacceptable, and I am surprised that in Ukraine it is considered normal that people with children who have special needs, they tell their stories in this way and are trying to find help in this way. And the task of Ukrainian Social Coalition is to speak for those who cannot speak and to defend and protect those who cannot protect themselves.
Den enda kontaktnätverk man kan vända sig till, att man är helt utlämnande, till exempel om man föder ett barn som Alona, och att då är man helt utlämnad till ödet, till media, till kampanjer.
And there is an impression that in Ukraine there is lack of control over situation, there is no proper network of social support by which we can solve this problem, and the families like this, they are just suffering, and they do not get proper attention and protection. And parents can draw attention only through the media, or if they provide this topic for wide discussion, and it shouldn't be the only way to resolve the problem.
När det blir som en självständighetsstat, så har detta problem varit att de grundläggande behoven för att bo i Ukraina har inte funnits överhuvudtaget. Vi har inte lyckats att bli en ekonomiskt och socialt stabil nation.
And this situation remains the same starting 1991 when our state emerged, and it looks like that what should have been done in social sphere was not done. And recent statistics of UNO, 80% of Ukrainian population is below poverty line, and 80% of population are living $5 per day. And I'm really concerned that people who are in the same situation, they earn $5 a day, and they have to find a way to resolve this problem. And this looks like a dead end. And this problem seems unsolved.
och hans familj för att kunna hjälpa Alona. Men det behövs som sagt konkreta förslag, reformer. Det är bara att Alexejs familj representerar tusentals familjer i Ukraina. Och vi kan inte bara vara nöjda med att gå till kyrkan och be för Alonas familj. Vi måste agera, inte bara för Alonas familj, för alla dessa familjer i Ukraina som är i akut behov av hjälp.
I believe that one of the missions of the Ukrainian Social Coalition is to mobilize Christian community in order that they be more active to resolve these problems and to improve conditions in our society. If state is not able to carry out one of the main tasks, people should act. That's why I call on all active Christians not only to go to church, and they should help, they should not step aside, they should provide help to those who are in need. And this is not enough. We, Ukrainian Social Coalition, we believe that there should be proper legislation. And we believe that there should be a draft law developed that would be for protection of rights of children with special needs. That's why this draft law should envisage in what way the rights be defended, and it should be stated what action should be taken by the state to defend the rights of these children, and how the system to support these children, how the system should work. That's why one of the main goals of Ukrainian Social Coalition is to create a special commission that would collect information about the situation in Ukraine concerning the families, like the family of Alena, and to address NGOs, volunteers, special centers to the families, to doctors and competent people in order that they could help to analyze the situation and to improve the situation and to establish functioning system of help for such people.
Ukraina. Att ukrainska staten ungefär betalar hälften av kostnaden för medicin per ett år.
Отож, я також хочу завершити тим, що в Україні...
So, I believe that in Ukraine there should be a reform in medical sphere, and the percent should, of medicine should be covered by the state. The same should be done with the process of rehabilitation and the provision of help in rehabilitation centers. 50% should be covered by state.
Ett barn som har särskilt behov, de kan inte ha samma statligt stöd som vanliga barn.
Ну і звичайно треба підняти питання про те, щоб підвищити допомогу.
We should increase help for the families with such children and to focus attention and to help children with the special needs. We cannot even compare what This we cannot compare the families with healthy children and the families who have disabled children. There should be a clear line, and we should work on this in order to we should provide proper help from the state to such families.
Ситуаційна Україна сам Альона ситуація.
А власне кажучи,
these steps that were described above, this is all implemented in Sweden, and this is how the system works there. So there should be changes introduced, otherwise there won't be productive and positive changes in this area. God bless us, our country, and all of us.
The next one will be Юлія Павловська.
Доброго дня. Мене звати.
I'm Юлія Павловська. I'm the founder of the charity fund Special Mother. Why I call it so? Because I believe that the healthy mother is very important for a healthy child, especially if it is a child which is special. I am covering a difficult way from 2013. My child has an early children's autism. I don't know, fortunately or unfortunately, the diagnosis was wrong, because in fact there were some problems. I will describe the problems, but we came out of this situation. The child is six, but she's developed as the 4.5-year-old child. I would like to mention the fund, and I'm ready for cooperation. That is why the fund was founded. After the new year, I received all the statutory documents. I have a very good experience of cooperation with the Kiev Regional Council and Vyshegoradsky District Administration and Vyshegoradsky Council, because I lived there in summer of 2016. Thanks to my efforts and thanks to my colleagues, we managed to receive from local self-government, from local authorities, 320,000 hryvnias for vouchers for a mother and child with special needs. I managed to receive from the state money for treatment of such children and for rehabilitation. I'm not a businessman. I invite you for cooperation. As to some figures, very briefly. By the end of the financial year of 2016, $13 million hryvnias returned to the accounts of the Ministry of Health of Ukraine, which were not used for the needs of children with autism. I believe that this is the crime against such children, because with my organization I united such families, but we are working not just with autists. Just because I am the mother of such a child, I have the support of some MPs of the Regional Council. They are ready to help us to prepare special programs according to which the state will be covering treatment and rehabilitation. Now I am developing such programs. It's very difficult for me to do it on my own. I invite you for cooperation. I am glad to meet you. And thank you for inviting. I am happy that I managed to express my point of view in support of this project. Education of children with autism in Ukraine. Officially, we don't have the rehabilitation, we don't have the basis. that the treatment basis, all the institutions are very different. My child is registered in the clinic of children's psychiatry. We are registered with Professor Marcinkowski. I'm just sharing your experience. I'm open for cooperation. In Facebook, there are two of my accounts, Yulia Pavlovska. It's easy to find me. I will be happy to cooperate with specialists and parents. Thank you.
Пані Юлія, до слова запрошується Тетяна Вишневська.
Тетяна Вишневська. Good afternoon. I'm Tetiana, the chairman of the Association of Multi-Children Families. And because my presentation is the final one, I would like to say the sooner we find money for treatment of Alena Lenka Demuchenses, we have to return her to a regular life so that she goes to school, so that she communicates to other children, so she lives the life just like others. I thank all who came, who helped this family, and I hope that there will be people who care, organizations that will join us in treatment of this child, will find money, will Alenka will recover, and this family will be the example for all families that have such children. I wasn't ready as to inclusive education in Ukraine. Very briefly.
Я сподіваюсь.
Ну да. Інклюзивна освіта в Україні.
Inclusive education in Ukraine. In Kyiv we have the state inclusive programs which are free in schools and kindergartens, and there is and such a class could be organized in any school and in any kindergarten.
Мацю вважаю потрібною, тому її оголосила. Дякую за спонтанність. Так, вибачте.
Дякую, колеги. Я так розумію, що ще є фінальне слово у пана.
I understand that Oleksiy has the final remark. Of course, I want to thank Volodymyr, Christian, Tetiana, Julia for drawing attention to this issue. And I want to congratulate my daughter with the birthday. I love you so much. Thank you.
Будь ласка, коротко.
Дуже
вдячний. I would like to thank Christian for talking about that in Ukraine. But what I would like to mention, Sweden managed to build socialism. We're just moving there. So I would love to live in the country which is so similar in its social insurance and the attitude to children as Sweden. But we need to do everything in our situation. I would like to say that we can do much. Starting with assistance to a child, a specific child, I invite you to join. This will be a great example. Those who fight, they win, and Jesus helps those who ask him for help. Thank you. Any questions or comments? Thank you.